have to bait that one out as well.
It means they aren't prioritizing a mid lane pick first.
No. Well, or there's another one in there that they want to really make sure works out and isn't Cassidy.
Or they're just trying to beat up Perm.
Yeah.
Be like, what you got, man?
Honestly, yeah, they sent all three bans at him. Now, Lulu did go through unbanned, though, and that gets picked up right away now for Loveland Shore.
Take Fun, he loves Orianna, he loves Lulu, he loves the shielding champions that provide teamfight utility to his team.
Well, they got a guy like Kuban who crushed last game, plays the Jaxes and Aurelias of the world, and sitting with a Lulu, it's going to work pretty well. So
Picks delivery system.
Yeah, it's the Picks delivery system, exactly. You said they were winning because of Picks last game. Now they actually have it on their team.
Surefire victory there. No.
Surefire victory. Well, it's Denali Esports now, 30 seconds to go. As you identified, Twitch is available right now. They could also grab pretty cream of the crop.
Here's the thing with Kobe, though, is that his win-loss ratio with Twitch is actually negative in solo queue.
Yeah.
So he's actually high up there in solo queue. He's in Challenger, but he's got about a 42% win rate with Twitch, which is not ideal. He's most likely going to go for a Lucian pick just because. But that leaves Twitch open over for Mockler, who played Twitch in both the round of 10 and round of 20, and put up a KDA of 9.25.
Yeah, this is interesting to me as Denial, because they know he'll likely go for Twitch anyway. Yeah. There's no way Wukong's a contested pick. The fact they're taking so long and picking unprioritized champions means either one, they're trying to kind of pick the heck out of people, or two, they're really not sure what they want to play right now. That they're lost in champs, like saying, you know what, just pick these that, whatever.
Yeah.
These are not power picks right now.
Well, Wukong is the most played for Uzi. It's not a contested pick like you said.
Exactly. You get that whenever you want.
Like, you... For right now, you would pretty much take your support and just be like, we want a top tier support right now. We want Morgana. We want something along that vein. And see what we can do with it.
Like, do it Loveland Shore to pick your dual lane real quick, right? Pick the cream of the crop in that one and go for it. But Lee Sin, once again, pick is going to come out through. Twitch does go over to Mockler. They're happy to play that champion. So Loveland Shore, really, they got more champs that they wanted. Twitch and Lulu were banned last time. They got them this game. They still get the Lee Sin. Like, they're having the best champs of their lives right now.
Yeah, Loveland Shore is playing this really well. They just banned three mid lane champions. Perm hasn't selected his. Of course, they get last pick. They'll most likely save it for their top laner because it's such a top lane heavy kind of tilty match. And big thing here for Super Ace is that his second most played is Sona behind Thresh, which they banned away. Wouldn't be surprised to see it. And also the nerf to Lifesteal Quintessences makes sustain in lane even more popular, even more potent, so you can win the lane just outright.
Yeah, so I'm going to see how this lane matchup goes out. Honestly, it just depends on what Loveland Shore has to keep the Twitch alive in lane. Because, 2-on-2s, Lucian Sona is super strong. Perm does go over to Ziggs. I like that choice a lot. I think it's the right choice to go for here. And so he'll have a much better time in team fights in Denial. I mean, they've got a real team fight competition right now. Wukong, Ziggs, Sona, like, you want some 5-on-5s in that case. And when you're fighting a Twitch, that's kind of the right idea. Loveland Shore going to make their last few choices. Blind pick Aurelia might come through for the top lane for Kuban. And a match sustain, maybe a Nami there to supplement the Twitch. I think those are good choices.
Yeah, the Nami is definitely a better laner than Sona. When you get to it, like just flat against each other, she has gank assistance more than Sona does.
Oh, yeah, true.
For sure, with the bubble. You're able to slow people down a lot more frequently than Sona is. She just has the power cord and slow under the innuendo. And overall, I think that's a great pick there by Libic, and great to recognize that they're going for a sustain war, and he'll most likely win.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting to watch for. I mean, Twitch definitely going to win the outscaling war as well. So,
speaking of fish.
Yep, outscales.
Anyway, the last pick here is going to be their top laner. Shuts down picking Ryze because Aurelia is really good against Ryze. And they're going to have to go with a team fight, and there's the presence with Shyvana.
Okay, I like Shyvana here because I think she can also stand up to Aurelia. Yeah. I think it's still a good Aurelia matchup. Like, I'm happy here right now if I'm Kuban. But this is going to be Denial, definitely looking for 5-on-5s, looking for team fights. Loveland Shore is interesting because their damage only comes from two real sources. It's really reliant on Kuban and Mockler to do well. If those lanes don't excel, there's no damage output to stop Shyvana, to stop Wukong, to stop Lucian. So that is a concern right now if you're Loveland Shore. But you've got dive buddies, you've got Lulu able to help, you've got Nami able to help as well when that really goes into the back line. So I think there's a real good chance Loveland Shore could win, just they need to get those right people ahead.
Yeah, and also, just thinking about it, the fact that a lot of the ultimates here synergize for Loveland Shore doesn't look like it, but they do. You can go ahead and use the knockup from your Wild Growth while a Tidal Wave is coming in. On use it on an Aurelia who dove in.
Yeah.
Knock them up. Tidal Wave is coming in at the same time Spray and Pray is being used, or Rat-a-tat-tat.
Yeah. And you make sure that you've got them all locked down. You make sure they can't get away from it.
It's kind of like a range engage fight, whereas the team fight from Denial is more of a just go wombo them, and that's it.
Yeah, and so we'll see how it pans out, right? You know, setting up for the Twitch versus just setting up and kind of everyone being able to participate there, right? Shyvana, a really big area of effect damage threat. She's it's interesting because, like, you know, if you want to compare Shyvana to Aurelia, Shyvana's a really big team fighter. Like, she'll damage probably all five members of the team, right? She'll knock them around, do a lot of AoE damage, and just is a good team fighter. Aurelia's very single target focused, right? It's very much like, I'm going to shut down this one guy.
Yeah.
And that is going to be something to watch for, is how they can both participate. Because the thing is, Ziggs will contribute way more damage than Lulu will in a fight, right? And so you have to be very mindful of the fact that you've got three significant damage sources on the side of Denial Esports to watch out for. And that's a concern. I like Denial's champ select here. I think they made a lot of correct choices.
Yeah, and at the same time, Mockler, though, on Twitch, if he can have the same type of game he had last game, he can. If he's the only damage threat, he's still enough as Twitch.
Potentially, yeah. It depends on the positioning, though.
The CC, the peel back with Lulu.
Yeah.
There's a lot of theory crafting going on here, and I understand, you know, there's always X variable.
Sure,
somebody comes in from the side, it's like, oh, well, he's dead.
And that's the main point, right, is when you're Twitch and your damage is through the roof, only if the positioning is good, right? Like, if your Gigantic is Kog'Maw, your Gigantic is Vayne, and the peel is there, then it's fine. You just kill one target at a time as they all go down. If your Gigantic is Twitch and they're peeling, but you're only hitting one guy, that damage falls off. Your Q steroid falls off, your ultimate falls off, and then you're a kind of a lackluster AD carry at that point with no steroids left. So it is something I want to watch out for as this fight goes on, but we're going to have to see what happens. A lot of CC available, and here we go. Lublin Shore, 1-0 so far in the series in this best of three. Take Fun's going to spot Perm.
Line of scrimmage coming out here. Take Fun is a big fan of that Ignite. There's Perm. He's got the defensive summoner now. Now he found it. And to put it into perspective, we talked about the difference in AoE team fight and the top laners. Aurelia only has one move that has even the potential to hit multiple people.
Yep.
That's her ultimate, and it kind of hits like a wet blanket.
Yeah.
Whereas Babunya, when his ultimate's up, every single one of his abilities is AoE. Just brings a lot of damage, magic damage, mixed damage to the fight, where Aurelia is pretty much just bringing physical damage to a single person with some true on the backside.
So, still the safe start for these guys. Interesting that they now put two wards down in that area, maybe expecting to get the first one swept away. Interesting that Super Aze did not open Trinket this time. He did in game one. But now a much more defensive start.
Interesting starts being formulated in Europe. We saw the two sweeper start from, I believe, the Copenhagen Wolves.
Yeah.
Who just had it on the jungler and had it on the support. Nice little trading there, but just going to be regen back up by the time minions actually meet each other.
This move, Mockler trinkets his own brush because he didn't see if people were around. He never saw the bottom lane of Denial, so he wanted to make sure that was going to be safe. He is. Kikas will be soloing his own buff, and he does it on the weak side of the map, so he should be safe to grab a two buff start there. Uzi, similar situation there. No leeches at all for these two junglers. So now neither team actually knows where these guys started. No vision was given, and no tells were given by the solo lanes or the duo lanes that would have leashed for them. So there's going to be very unknown junglers here.
There's going to be a lot of trading in this bottom lane so that they can try and set up a push or try and set up a gank by the time that the 3-minute mark hits, because these are both very gank-heavy junglers in the early game.
Yeah. Let's see what happens this one. So right now, second buff started out by Uzi. Goes right for it after he started his red buff there. He's going to have Smite about at the right time for this one, but I believe he won't quite be level 3. Kikas did take Wolves. Now he's going for his own red, so not too far behind really in this one anyway. Going to have the standard roughly 3 to 3.5 minute jungle exits if they want them. Early lane push did go to Denial, so Kobe's going to have level 2 before Mockler. Of course, that's been reached now, but we'll see how that battle continues.
And it looks like the junglers are just farming up their jungle right now. There aren't any wards anywhere in the river for the bottom lane right now. Instead, they're just going to farm up. They're going to just negate the or neglect the 3-minute gank window timer.
Mm-hmm.
Instead, just be okay with getting creeps, getting gold.
One thing, though, to keep in mind, though, is TakeFun's actually missed a number of CS, like, for no reason in this lane. He's actually missed 6 to the 2 that Perm has missed in just the straight-up one-on-one. that could be, I mean, it's a really early to say, but like that could become a problem if he just can't land the minion kills on Lulu.
Kickus is invading. He's coming around the side. Wasn't seen by the ward of Perm.
All right, let's see if they can make the play. Going to land the Q. Going to land a little bit of damage right there and jumps into turret range and hops right back out. Not too much damage taken to that one, but Perm down to half HP.
And now he's going to have to play even more defense against Take Fun, who brought Ignite to the fight. Now off on the side, though, they know that Kickus took a tower shot. He's a little bit lower. So at the same time, Uzi's going to go for an invade. He's going to try to find Lee Sin.
Oh, it's going to be all kinds of interesting if they do get into a battle right here. There's the wolf. Oh, he's got a bunch of damage. Goes in. Oh, picked up there by Uzi, I think, got it.
Yeah, gets a level 4 off of it. So he has a level advantage. He's bullying around the Lee Sin in his own jungle just because of that tiny bit of damage that he got. It's basically as if he had an extra spell over Lee Sin when he engaged.
True.
Which is huge. If somebody takes some damage, you see them take it, go bully them in the jungle.
Excellent play by these guys. A little bit of a trade going on there. Nice there by Livik. Did go for the blue GP10, the Spell Thief's Edge. Early recall and teleport for Babunia for a second Doran's Blade and a ward. Maybe a potion or two just to keep himself safe. So wants to bully up the lane with that one. And gonna see what else he can get with that. Meanwhile, Kuban has not backed yet, but is losing health in this one. Mokler also losing a bunch there. So this Sona plus Lucian pick has worked very, very well for Denial.
Yeah. The early game of Lucian combined with the Hymn of Valor from Sona is just doing a lot of damage in the early game. And I guess their goal for Lublin Shore is just keep the CS up, stay alive, and try to scale into that late game. Look at that. TP from Aurelia gets himself 3 Doran's Blade. He sees what Babunia did, but look at that.
Perm has to heal early. Big damage comes through. Nice Ignite, the flash away. Perm.
Sticking.
Last tick, that's enough. That will be first blood. The shield from Kickus gets him an assist after the fact, and that's going to be the push into the turret. Really nice there by Lublin Shore. Take Fun making the play.
Best gank. Just jump in, shield. All right, you're good.
Yep.
Got an assist.
Even block any damage, doesn't even matter. Kuban, though, he actually teleports back with 3 Doran's Blades.
Yep.
So the arms race right now in the top lane. Need a lot of arms to carry a lot of Doran's Blades, but right now Kuban has more.
He's got 4 blades on his one right now anyway.
Yeah.
It's Aurelia. He'll throw him later when he gets his 6.
Sure, Aurelia doesn't actually need hands. She actually telekinetically controls blades.
That's true.
So, no wonder he can hold 3.
Dionia for you. And up in the top lane, we do see that that's actually coming up big for him. He's down on mana currently. He's up in CS. But Babunia, what can he do? Can he take advantage of this?
He's going to try right there. Level 6 goes for the all-in, doing a fair bit of damage, but not too terribly much. Kuban's got to be a little bit careful, though. And he's going to sustain up under the turret. He's fine.
Yeah. Very hard to deal with somebody under turret. Like we said, Shyvana's abilities are all AoE, so she will immediately take turret aggro if you can just run up with Burnout on.
You know, I actually saw a really cool move by a Shyvana the other day. So basically, Shyvana, her TP was going to be up in about 20 seconds, and he knew his opponents wasn't going to be for like a minute and a half. And so he goes for a really bad trade, just all ins, just to deal damage. Dragon forms out, recalls, heals up, TP's back to lane. Knowing he's going to like, I don't care how much health I lose, I'm going to go back to full regardless. And then come back to lane and his opponent's at half HP.
Yeah, teleport advantage is really big. We might see something along those lines here because they are staggered just a bit.
Yeah.
So Babunia will have his up first.
Well, he actually walked back to lane for this one, though. He will have teleport up for the dragon fight if they want it. His TP's in about 30 seconds. He's got about a 30-second window over the Aurelia, but 3 Doran's Blades and a cloth armor. The recall for Kuban, 3 Doran's Blades and the Ruby Crystal. They are just vying for that one small item lead every single time. The shove, the recall. So
I see your early game stats, and I raise you a little bit more.
Yeah, exactly. It's actually interesting, though, that Babunia did go cloth armor, being that Aurelia, especially as you get close to level 9, is very much true damage based. Though the 3 Dorns is a lot of physical still.
Yeah, it's a lot of auto attack damage here from this entire team. So you may be just trying to rush the boots. Go ahead and negate some of Twitch's damage. Of Aurelia's.
It's definitely an AD-heavy team for Lublin Shore. That's very true.
And the fact that Lulu doesn't do as much in the late game.
Yeah, we will see with this one. Perm, level 6, gets the blue buff there. Kuban going for a trade against Babunia. These guys definitely losing health bars on both sides, but 15 health per attack is a decent amount. Malkia getting a big trade back, though. Good bubble on a Kobe, though. The ward spots
him. Level 6 is almost here.
Oh, they've got to be careful. Super A's is going in for the trades, though. Mach takes another Q on the backside, getting healed by the Nami.
At the same time.
They've got to be careful, though.
Uzi's off on the side. He has 6, too. The ultimates are coming down.
Wow, I'm surprised there's no sweepers picked up, though. Because I was looking at like, oh, will he gank? But there's no sweeper. He can't know if there's wards. And in fact, there are, so he backs off. But no sweeper for these ganks surprised me a lot.
Level 6 is here almost for the support, and the fact that they have the vision coverage, and you can't deny that vision. No ganks coming out. It's just that one from the basically solo kill mid lane.
And keep in mind, it's BF Sword versus Vamp plus Longsword here. Malkler couldn't even get the Cutlass combine out, whereas Kobe does have the BF Sword, so just the battle damage is so much higher there for Denial.
He was chunking him out, and the fact that he got that lead is culminating in the CS and the advantage he's creating, because he's just zoning Malkler off. Because if Malkler takes a Light Slinger after Piercing Light, it's going to chunk him down a ton.
He really will. So right now, though, Lee Sin not going to find his way into the top lane. Kickus doesn't get any ganks right here. Only 6 minions separate the top laners there, so they're trading very equally. The Super is getting a bit aggressive, but he's got the health bar lead, so he's going to be all right.
So, you know, early Chalice for Libic, so you can go ahead and keep his mana up to constantly ebb and flow.
That's a good choice. I like that.
And he'll eventually get the Mikhail's, which will stop the Crescendo.
There you go. Dragonform going in one more time. But when you're getting some decent damage there, the Burnout hitting pretty hard on the Kuban. Just once again getting the shove underneath the turret, but a 2 minion lead is not very much when you're going to see us pretty much all of these right here for Kuban. And Kickus does come around after the ward times out. They've got to be careful on this one. Kicks him in. There's a stun as well. Flash by Babunya, but here comes Wukong. He's going to flash. Can he get the ulti? No. Flash away by Kuban keeps him safe. They're going to trade spells in this one.
If the Q had landed, the Sonic Wave would have been a Sonic Wave into a kick, into a Resonating Strike afterwards. May have been the kill there. May have been the damage that they needed to pick up Babunya, but instead just a little bit wide. And a good juke there by Babunya.
That does force a teleport out of Kuban, though, so if the jungler can make his way down to the bottom side of the map, it's going to be an easy lead for Denial to go for a dragon there. Tidal Wave used by Libic to stop recalls. Looks like, actually, Lublin Shore wants to keep the health bars of Denial down and make a play off of that. They'll burn a cooldown just to stop recalls.
Interesting. Malkler has a ton of sustain between himself, the Vamp Scepter, and the fact that he has the ebb and flow from Nami, that he's able to start pushing Kobe back if a good Aqua Prison lands. Now,
here we go.
Because of that health advantage, they're able to go ahead and get themselves this dragon.
And that's what the Tidal Wave was for, is, you know, just to buy those 30 extra seconds, make Denial kill one more wave, and then be too low to fight for this one. So Dragon goes over to Lublin Shore, 800 gold lead, Kickus gets out. A very well-secured situation.
You're sitting in this bush.
Oh, no. Super Ace, why are you there right now? Twitch ult pop. Bubble's going to miss. Will they flash for that one? No, they won't. It's a trade of Ignite for Flash. Not as bad as it could have been.
Yeah. The Tidecaller's Blessing came onto Malkler. They thought the slow may have been enough at that point. Ended up using the Ignite. But here comes Kickus. Nope. They see him, though. They get the information. But he's going to continue to ward up. Go for some counter jungler.
And that's the cool thing about counter jungler right now, is he can only ever run into Wukong right now. He sees Ziggs, he knows the bot lane recalled. This gives time for Kickus to take these wolves down, get wards up, prepare for a blue steal in about a minute and a half. Remember that Uzi did go for red buff to blue buff, so it's like a 13 minute respawn. And if Denial are ready for this one.
They know, they ping that the ward is in that bush, but Kickus completely ignored it. He walked around it. He's unseen right now.
And Uzi is right around that blue buff. Kickus not going to land the Q. This is not going to be too much. Nice Savage Charge keeps him safe. He's going to be right for this one. Now they see that Lee Sin's on that side of the map. All these junglers know their buffs are respawning fairly soon.
You want to be healthy when that happens too, or else you can't contest them. And now Uzi, he's going for gank on Take Fun.
Good damage there. Nice knock. It prevents all the damage. Very well played there by Lulu. But he does lose an ulti for it.
Yeah, that's true. He's not going to have that to contest if there is an invasion that comes in. And now, actually, more cards in the hands of Denial right now, and they ping the blue buff. They want to go for it.
All right, we'll see if they can go. Ziggs is on the way. Lulu will get the recall back. And look at this, a nice push in the bot lane as well by these guys. But it's a 2-on-2 regardless. Doesn't actually have much bearing on the top side. But Babunya is still pushing on Kuban pretty well. And there we go. Uzi going to get the ward over the wall, and there's the start.
Yep, Lulu is not going to be there in time for this. No vision. Picks it up for himself.
Picked up by Wukong, and there comes the attack, though. Big damage comes in, but that's the clone that they hit there. Nice Satchel Charge keeps the team at bay as well. Denial there Gotta be a bit careful. Perm's coming in, take Fun. He's gonna land the flash, Glitterlands, the Ignite picks up the kill. Blue buff goes to take Fun anyway. There's the Whimsy. Q onto Perm's gonna land despite the summoner heal, and he gets in onto the minefield. Half HP, no wild growth though is available. Perm gonna dodge those last skill shots and he'll get out.
So take Fun ends up getting their blue anyway, and he gets a kill as well. Now they get to invade the jungle. A little bit aggressive there by Uzi, and also the fact that they went that route out of the jungle, because that's the way that their mid laner was, where Perm was, but instead of splitting up.
Or even running directly north.
Look at that, Mockler.
Wow, nicely played right there. A lot of CC coming through. The damage, all you need when you got Exhaust. Shundo used before there, and Libic forced well far away.
Mockler was way too far up there with no summoner spells available to him, and Libic just didn't have the peel available either. Now Take Fun, he's making his way down bottom. He's gonna Whimsy past the ward, see if it'll be enough.
He's going to try to make the play level 10 on him. Super Ace will walk it up a ward. Kobe, he's got to be careful on this one. Can he dash away on the slow? Oh, he does dodge the cube. Goes in for Libic. Can't go find it out. Forces the flash out from it as well, though. There's a W. The heal coming through. Take Fun still trying to go for the trade, but he's got to be careful. He's still putting a 1-on-2. Is forced back on this one. And Ziggs plus Wukong also roaming down. They did get spotted by a ward on the way over, but Loveland Shore not looking to retreat.
And Kickass is doing his red buff right now. Let's see what they can do. They put down a pink ward, and they know that there's many wards in there, but now TakeFun's gonna walk straight up and find it.
He's gonna know he's spotted, but goes right through. Anyway, needs to get back to his lane in time. The rest of the team's gonna go back and rejoin their old places, so nothing major really grabbed. Kickass grabs his red and level 9. He's actually a level up on Uzi here. Wards get traded back and forth there. Blue buff's gonna go to Perm as well, so looks like 20 minutes is gonna be the respawn of the blue buff.
So far, it's just been slightly better map movement by Loveland Shore, just like in last game, where they got advantages off.
Look at that. The playmaking in the bottom lane, though, is going exceptionally well. Mockler has got to be super careful, does land the stealth, but if he goes to Tri-Brush, he gets hit by a pink ward. Gets spotted by Kobe. Dash in. One more attack will do it. Kickass shows up, gets the shield. Kobe! Oh my god, Kickass has missed so many Qs this game. Cannot find the kill.
Slams the ground in anger.
Ziggs' ulti gets him. Nicely played right there. They trade kills back and forth, though. Kobe's got to be careful. Big damage comes through. Flashes. The wall goes down to Kickass anyway. The red buff burn is enough.
Who needs landing Qs when you have a red buff?
Yep.
Good enough. And a Ziggs on your team who will pick up the kill for you after the fact.
So 2-1. Loveland Shore actually come out ahead on that one.
Yeah.
Despite everything.
It looked like Uzi was, I was talking about how Loveland Shore has just been out-rotating them slightly.
Mm-hmm.
But look at that. They do it again. They end up on top of that fight. Misses it. Misses the E as well. And then Uzi just walks straight into it without knowing that the kick across 2 was huge. He hit that Q and lines it up with the burn more than enough from his red buff and his lizard.
The two-man kick was definitely awesome right there. That got them those kills.
Yeah.
So very well played.
Silence the critics.
Yep.
Can't land a Q, but can land a kick, which is arguably harder.
Yeah. Two-man kick. Yeah, like, it's not even just a skill shot. You've got to like line up their opponents as well. But there we go. Dragon in 40 seconds. Loveland Shore already trying to wrest control of this. You're seeing the two Sightstone Wearers running around, getting wards down to the jungle. Pink wards on the entrances as well to guarantee there's no vision watching any of this. It's going to be hard fought.
But there's a ward right on the dragon.
Well, yeah.
Yep.
But, you know, that's less important. All right, well, Boots of Moby on cooldown for Kickass. Going to push Perm away. That ward going to be around for a little while. The turret very, very low on health. He's one wave away from killing this one. So Take Fun has to be careful about this one. Perm does get pushed around a long way, which is going to give a push lead there. Bottom turret does go to Kobe and Super Ace, though. You got to say, Denial still, despite losing a couple of kills, not really getting disheartened there. They've actually built the gold lead for themselves off their extra turret, pushing this bot lane pick, working exceptionally well. At first, I was like, you know, I don't know why you grabbed Lucian so early. He's not contested, but because of Lucian and Sona, they're up 40 CS.
Yeah, it's 1,400 gold. He didn't really have an option of taking Twitch because of his champion pool, and he wanted to deny it from Mockler. At the same time now, Loveland Shore, they're actually going to go for this dragon. It's seen, but there's no TP here from Kuban. It's a 3-on-4.
Yeah, but Tidal Wave's going to slow them down just enough that they're not going to get their way in. Loveland Shore do earn the dragon. That was very well played by these guys. So off they go back to the normal spots. And Denial now have to suffer through a 1,000 gold deficit. Takefun goes back to the mid lane, holding just minus 20. Not too bad against Perm, but you know, we said Perm was laning pretty well last time. And Takefun, 3-0-1. He's found his way into fights much better than Perm has.
He's exploiting what we talked about earlier, where Perm doesn't seem to roam out of the lane too often or at the right times. He's very reactive in that. He's not making the plays. He's following Takefun up, who's already made a play by the time he gets there. So Takefun up and kills down in CS, which is how you would expect against somebody like Perm.
Yeah, that's what you want.
Yeah.
Up and kills down in CS is generally the way to play League of Legends if you can. Sets your team up for success there. Again, 1,000 gold lead there. Mm-hmm. Kickus does have Sweeper, jumps
around.
Over. Babunia gets stunned up. Now, do they have the trade they want? Dragonforce Pop kicks him back into the team. Babunia does still have Flash. The Q is landed from Lee Sin. Can he get to the wall in time? The slow is there. Flashes it. Kickus shows up, lands the Q. One more attack will do it. Kickus! Oh no, he can't do enough! And Kick is not going to get the kill on Babunia. He was one attack away and couldn't find it. Uzi comes to defend. Nothing picked up there.
Very, very close. And now Perm, he started roaming top that time, but he ends up giving up CS for it now because they're on his middle turret. They have to reinforce this with three members. And we talked about the bottom lane, how it was so impactful for Lublin Shore last game. It's complete opposite this time. And now the CS lead is in Kobe's favor, as well as the kills. Mockler's just been shut down, and they're going to try to give him some CS so he can just be that late-game Twitch.
We'll see what else they can find with this one then, with Twitch still grouping up. Interestingly, he's still got a while to go, though. Twitch, no Blade of the Ruined King. 20 minutes in, no Blade of the Ruined King is exceptionally slow. I assume with his recall, he's got it now, finally. Tidewave does land on a Perm, though. Bubble, not quite going to land, but the damage comes through from Lee Sin. South Charge gets him back to the base, but or back to safety, I should say. But
towards his base.
Yeah, towards the base. Back
he touches the turret,
base.
It's like tag. He's like, safe, this is base.
Yeah.
You can't get me here.
Safe zone. We're going to be all right. Ooh, nice glitter lens keeps them in a good spot. But the crescendo coming out from Super A's. The Ziggs Bomb as well. Good damage comes through. There's the engage as well. Good damage. Kick is forced back for this one. Glitter lens keeping him pretty safe, though. And Kobe can't find quite any more damage. Mockler style stuff looking for a play. Maybe, again, the dive in by Shyvana. But Kuban, he's happy to take this fight. Again, no flash up the dash in.
Wow.
Flash auto attack. Bad choice by Babunia. Kuban winning that one easily.
The Blade Surges there from Kuban were so good. Blade Surging to a minion to kill it so it doesn't put it on cooldown, and he also gets the gap closer. Meanwhile, they get the mid turret, and
yeah,
they get a kill up top. Solo kill, and now they're going to invade.
Ooh, blue buff steal, safeguard away. That is going to be safe for Lublin Shore. And this game is a lot like the last one. It's
dead even. Right now.
Yeah, well, it's Lublin Shore winning in kills, right? And unsurprisingly, Kuban's doing awesome. Down in CS, up in kills. No big surprise in this one. Denial are winning the turret push game. They are getting themselves into the right location and taking turrets down. Problem is, when they fight Lublin Shore wins.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, absolutely. When they just try to brawl them down, they just get beaten down. And now the Blade of the Ruined King is completed on Mockler, but it's going to be the Bloodthirster Trinity Force for Kobe. Very close to being completed here. And this top lane is actually just going to start going in Kuban's favor even more at this point. He's hitting power spikes. He's got the level 13, so he has two abilities maxed. He's able to just take it to the Shyvana, who's now more of a team fight tanky presence.
Yeah, Shyvana didn't build for dueling, right? Sunfire Cape first, right? No Ruin King, no great sustain. Yeah, he's got Phantom for now, but whatever. Irelia already starting to build tanky. Kobe makes the right choice to get out right at the right time. Standard BT Triforce for him.
Now, Mockler's more than happy to just try and catch up in CS because he's down in levels, just now hitting level 12 off that wave. There's Kobe, well on his way to level 13 at this point.
Okay, so Denial, can you cash in on the Triforce power spike and do something with it? On the Lucian, specifically.
Mm-hmm.
Make the siege happen. You've got rank 2 ulti. You've got a great team fight comp. Crescendo's back up. Wukong is level 11. This is pretty much the best possible time for Denial while Twitch is still not effective.
Yeah, I think in the minute when Dragon comes up, if Kobe has enough gold to complete his Trinity Force, they're definitely going to fight it and definitely force the fight as much as they possibly can to just accelerate their gold totals, accelerate the game for them. Because right now, they've taken all of the outer turrets. There's still outer turrets for Lublin Shore to take. Whereas now, in order to start pushing up, they need ward coverage. And in order to get wards, you need money, so why not get the dragon? They're going to be in the perfect position to do so. And we do see the bat coming out here from Kobe. If he gets 24 CS, he does. They're going to go straight for the dragon and try to fight it with this power spike.
Okay, well, we'll see if they can do it, because right now Lublin Shore took ward control. They own the eastern jungle. They own the bottom river as well. They even got some pink wards still there from last time to help keep that vision control where they want it. They're now going to start now. T minus 25 seconds, and they're starting to try to get dragon control. Can they do it? There's one from Perm. There's a sweeper coming out as well. They're doing the best they can for this one, but we'll have to see. Kickus, this is well-timed. 15 seconds till dragon and blue buff will go to take fun. Make his way back over. 10 seconds, jumps over the wall. They know dragon's the goal. Now, can they get there?
Uzi still has his flash available, so he can actually use his ultimate and then flash and close distance. There's the TP for the flank by Kuban, but if they section him off, the team is split. If they make a decisive move onto one side and keep their AD carry kind of just in the back, like if they fight in this chokehold, they'll be fine.
Taito's going to earn them some control, though. They're going to get all their team now up over the wall, and there we go, the engage onto him. He's going to flash out. Ziggs Bomb hits nothing. Twitch off on the side, but no one's threatening him, so he's getting damage down on the squishies in the back line. Perm has to back up. There's the engage. The kick in, but it's not going to find too much. They find Sona, though. Kickus stays alive, actually. Just barely runs away on this one, and now the chase is on. Kuban finds himself a double kill. A third person goes down. Livik executes and picks up the kill on that one. Still running away. Now only two members alive. Kuban going to force everybody away. I do not see Denial getting anything off this.
That was not the most concise call, the clear call there, who they're going after. Uzi's ultimate could have been lined up better, but there's going to be a stun off of this from the Equilibrium Strike.
Huge damage comes through, flash forced away by Kobe. That's the dragon. That's three kills picked up, and a great fight for Lublin Shore.
And a 4K gold lead now coming into this. We're going to watch this again. The tidal wave is blown here, but Bunya uses his ultimate off on the right, and Uzi follows him, but it was a knock-up onto one, and Uzi's like, all right, I don't know who I'm going. Now I'm just zoning here, but I'm not zoning the Twitch. I'm not zoning the threats. I was zoning Kuban, who goes straight for the backline when they re-engage, and they're already low. Gets in there, picks up multiple members of their team, gets their tanky. Look at that. They can't do anything. They're on the retreat after that because they split. Their front line went off to the right and left their backline vulnerable to Twitch with the rat-a-tat-tat that they kind of came out, and then they just flooded in, and it's like, uh-oh, we have to retreat and try to cap this off, but they couldn't.
Yeah, Lublin Shore managed to get the team fight the way they wanted. The tidal wave forced Denial back. The wards saw them like up above the river, and you just had the easiest spray and pray of your life. No one threatening. Again, you talk about the engage going on the wrong champions. So Lublin Shore find the way to make that fight work exceptionally well. Almost a 4,000 gold lead now for these guys 26 minutes in. Looking very good in this matchup. Once again, they can just wait for Twitch to keep scaling up. Phantom Dancer now done to this champion. Played the Rune King Force already done. Last Whisper, the next pickup soon. Kickus level 13, keeping up with pretty much everyone there. And look at this now, the turret game finally going Lublin Shore's way. Bottom lane outer is gone. Kuban got the top lane after he killed Babunia in that 1-on-1, you know, 8 minutes ago or so, but it's only getting better from here.
The ultimate's here from Uzi, with the priority of picking the Wukong early for himself,
yeah,
and just getting himself on that comfort champion, are not coming up as big as you would imagine. He's gotten, I think, one person in his last two ultimates.
Yeah.
And he still had flash available, because you can ulti and then flash into the team and knock up multiple people and just get yourself back into the fight.
Yep.
Instead, he hasn't been saving it. He's been going straight for the support. He's been going on to non-priority targets instead of locking them up.
So let's see what else they can do here, because mid lane now under fire. The correct targets right now. How well can Denial reach this Twitch? The main damage source on the team.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, Kuban's big and he's not easy to deal with an AoE comp, so good luck on that one. But yeah, how safe is Mockler going to be? You've got a Lulu, a Lee Sin, and a Nami all there to potentially support you.
It's funny, too, because Mockler's been shut down all game. He's 0-2-3, and he's about 30 CS down over his lane opponent, who's Kobe's been doing really well this game.
Yeah.
But hasn't been a presence in team fights that people have to be extremely aware of. The back line is just so vulnerable. Babunia and Uzi have been abandoning it for the engage. Whereas the kite back from Take Fun and the counter engage from Kickus and Kuban is coming up really big.
It absolutely is. So Difficulties abound right now for Denial. Can they find the fights the way they want to? Can they actually get onto the people that are cutting away from them? Right now, that hasn't been the case. 4,000 gold with Loveland Shore ahead, and they're playing the slow game. Of course, sieging against Ziggs is really freaking hard. I think it's going to be hard for them to go into that lane that he's in and actually make pressure there. They've got to do the split pushing type game. Aurelia will get the push going on. Twitch, get to the point where you can actually beat up his Lucian one-on-one. At this stage, I think you actually can. This is the right set of items for Twitch to win that battle.
And the thing, too, is that Twitch can just leave the lane, hang out somewhere between top and middle if you're sieging, and then just show up. And it's like, oh, Babunyu, you were trying to split push against Kuban. You're dead.
Yep.
Because now it's a two-on-one. And just completely take over the game in terms of map pressure. Denial, if they can't push up, which it looks like they aren't going to be in a position to do so unless the teamfight goes really astray for Loveland Shore, they're going to have to start warding up their own jungle. Not just with regular sight wards, but with vision wards too.
Yeah. One thing to keep in mind as well, I'm kind of thinking about, you know, what plays make
He's
what
fast.
Not. Ooh, Super Ace is forced off to the side, has to flash away after Crescendo. That will keep him safe in this one. Looks like nothing really big going to happen, and they're going to trade spells and back out. But in terms of Loveland Shore, right, it's like they're not really in a rush this game because they can keep sitting with Twitch, and there's no timer on this game for them where, like, you've got to win by 35 minutes or whatever. And at the same side, they can't really easily dive. Denial's actually warded up their mid lane turret very well. Pink ward left-hand side, bunch of green wards in the bottom right. There's not a lot of easy ways in, but if you just brute force it down enough, if Takeman just goes in there, maybe they can just do enough. Look at the attacks coming in from Twitch. They finally get the turret down. And look at this. It's going to force Denial all the way back on this one. Well played, Loveland Shore.
Yeah, and there's a large wave down bottom. Mockler wants that.
Great.
Gonna actually put him even in CS.
Yeah, well, they're going to...
Coming back from that huge deficit.
They've caught up very nicely there. Nice sound charge, but Kickus is going to be okay with this one. Just jumps to a pink ward, and he's on his way out. Blue buff goes over towards Take Fun one more time after the turret goes down. And there's nothing for Denial to answer with. The waves are not pushed up. Outer turrets are already dead. Dragon's off the table. This farm, untaxed.
Yeah. Completely gets it for himself, but at the same time, they're trying to collapse around him here. And Uzi just warding up. He knows the dragon's up in 40 seconds. Doesn't put vision in the pit, puts it around. So that means they're going to be there for the fight first. Or at least that's their plan.
That is their plan. Well, that is one thing. Denial have done a really very good job of warding this game. They've got wards down. Problem is they're not getting the right type of fights. They're being outpositioned.
Yeah.
You know, damage is coming in from random locations they're not expecting in some cases. And they're just not able to do the battle. I mean, like, Super Ace got caught, burned Crescendo, burned Flash. They could no longer team fight for their turret.
They're getting out macroed and microed just by like a quarter of a point.
Yeah.
Just these tiny, tiny little things. They're there with the ward coverage. It's not like their ward coverage is lacking. They'll get it there. They'll be like, okay, this is the fight that we need to fight. But then they fight it, and it kind of goes astray for them because the call in the fight is not 100% there. See, they warded up the dragon, but they didn't ward the dragon itself. And now they aren't there in time, and they have to give it up.
I think that in general, I mean, the lanes are in a position where they can.
Yeah.
Like, Loveland Shore got the push in because they're stronger on the map now, right? They're using the 5,000 gold lead to say, you have to back up from us. You know we'll kill you. Pushes up. This is great. Now we can dragon, and you know we'll kill you, so don't try.
Yep.
Denial need to find the right kind of fight. The kind of things that Loveland Shore was doing last game to get back into the game, right? The tables are turned right now, where it's LBS looking to go in, make some plays. Denial needs to find something over-aggressive and punish for it. And I don't know if they will.
It's me!
Mockler now has his last whisper completed, so he will just shred straight through Babunya if he's on the front line with all that attack speed he's accumulated. And Loveland, they have to, you know, they have the right play here. They have the gold advantage, they have the wards in the enemy jungle, they got all the outer turrets, so now they're sieging tier 2s. Denial was in this spot, but they didn't have the gold lead enough because they didn't contest the dragons, and they did. Actually, they did contest the dragon, but it didn't go well for them. That they couldn't ward up the enemy jungle and start pushing up like Loveland Shore is doing with ease.
You're seeing it pay off right here. There we go. Bottom lane, the teleport coming in as well, taking turret shots just to make sure it goes even easier for them. And there's going to be turret number 4 now for Loveland Shore. 7,000 gold now to lead. This number keeps growing for them. They're making all the right choices. Mach looking aggressive, trying to make a play here. Does not land the slow, nothing picked up, but mid lane tier 2 could be available soon.
And I like that he teleported to the minion that the turret was on, so it made it invulnerable. Even when the Culling came out, they still had that little bit of minion wave left.
And it worked out for the minion kill, and it worked out for the turret kill. So, Perm taking a bit of poke. Again, these Ziggs siege defense. Right now, Lebanon Shore playing around it very well. Kickus pulls the Rebuff into the brush and smites it away. Nicely picked up. Q onto Lucian, won't follow it though. Perm coming around. This could be a little bit too much. Is this the fight for the Nile? There comes the Tidal Wave. Libic trying to disengage. Looks like he will do so. Nice Tidal Wave keeps the team safe.
Usually Tidal Wave, you're like, oh, it's a lackluster ultimate, but he's using it correctly this game, mm-hmm. for Libic.
Doing a very good job of this one. Unfortunately for him, not the same kill participation as the first one. Only one quarter, last game 100%. It's rather actually take fun on that Lulu, the one that was banned away in game one. First picked here in game two, and he's doing freaking awesome with it.
When you adjust your picks and bans, and you say, we don't want to deal with the Thresh, you leave something else open. Immediately gets first picked here. So take fun coming up big on that champion, both in CS and in map pressure. So before he was down in CS, now he's even. Now he's just trying to apply the damage to the team and be utility for
yeah.
Twitch. Big thing with Twitch is the fact that he's immobile. You have a lot of ways to keep him safe now with Lulu.
You absolutely do. Libic taxed to CS, what a scumbag.
Huh.
No reason to do that, man.
Put his Spell Thieves on cooldown, too. It's Frost Fang. What is that?
Well, at least there's no one around. But actually, that actually removed one possible gold from the team because one gold from the Mastery is only going to go to him. Yep. So unfortunate here. But you know what? I think they're still going to do okay. That one gold, unlikely to make it. You know, I'm going to say as a caster, I don't think the one gold is going to make a difference this game. Whether they win or lose, it won't be on that one gold on Libic, whether this game is won or lost.
I don't know.
Call me on it if you want.
No. Anyway, they go ahead and they're pushing up right now. They see that Mockler's bottom just free farming, but now they're going to go for this turret.
They're going to backdoor it. They've got a while to go. Nice crescendo on a kick. So good damage comes through, but Bubble is going to knock them all away. No engage from Wukong, but Take Fun, half HP. He's got to be careful. Takes some McHales. Didn't necessarily need it, but he does stay healthy on this one. The Nile, they're finding ways to keep themselves safe, but Lebanon Shore is still the lead on gold. Kuban finds a stun on the Uzi. He's got to be careful, though. Bomb comes in towards Libic, takes a shield. Lebanon Shore getting a little bit sloppy. There's a Tidal Wave, the engage. No one's going to hit by the ulti. Does put the team up. There's the bubble onto Perm and the engage. Uzi knocked up, though. Finds literally no one with the ulti. Flashes and gets Kuban, and that's it. That is not enough, and the kill is picked up onto the enemy jungler. Now Babunya forced to run away. He is low. Kuban gets away safely, and it's a 2-0 for Lebanon Shore.
They can't get onto Mockler if they blow their ultimates on the support if they try to get onto Libic. Mockler's just completely on the other side of the fight, just using Rat-Tat-Tat and picking people off. They're all extremely low here for Lebanon Shore, but that
hooks
it there, but Kobe.
Not gonna get this one just yet, but Libic's gotta be a bit careful. Takes the Culling, gets a shield, flash, keep him safe. But that is a flash down for that Culling. So it's like the Nile, they're starting to feel like impatient. They have these big team fight ultimates that they're never getting the ability to use on more than one person. Wukong, Cyclone, the Crescendo from Sona, the good plays by Kobe individually, and Super Ace to follow him up do earn them the turret. Perm gets that one. Like, they're able to deal some damage in these cases, but the 5-on-5s have yet to be positioned in a way that Denial could capitalize on.
Yeah, they haven't been able to just get in the fight, get to Mockler, which is the big person that they're all trying to support here and all trying to peel for on Lebanon Shore. And it also is reflected in their builds. You see Kickus last game had the Hex Drinker second item. Instead neglects it, goes straight tanky, Randuin's Banshee's Veil, so that he can be more of a frontliner for Mockler.
Absolutely. And it's the right choice in this one. You're going to see now the ward coverage game going back and forth there. Wukong off to the side. Ziggs ulti not going to be in time. Nice smite away. That's Kickus picking it up. And now can they go in for the next fight? Babunya a little bit low. Kuban's got to be a bit careful. Gets a stun onto Uzi. But of course, the ultis aren't there. Tidal Wave's going to stop the engage. The
Stalk's
going to walk away from this one. Mockler is around putting the damage on. Kobe's got to be careful. The jump on in. He gets it. Kuban does make that one happen. On to Kobe. 1-0 plus Baron. Lebanon Shore can keep going.
And now Libic has the movement speed, doesn't do anything with it. Dragon is up in 8 seconds right now. They're going to go straight for that. But Mockler, he actually wants that bottom wave too. It looks really juicy.
Yeah, this is standard for Lebanon Shore right there. They play it very slow and measured when they get their leads. They could go for mid-tier 2. Most likely they don't go for it. They're going to wave clear. They're going to take the Dragon. They're going to get that farm onto Twitch. The slower gameplay here. And use their 5-on-4 for map control. Good damage in the perm. Back on Alf.
Mockler's farming up that huge wave bottom before he gets to the dragon. Now there's a contest over the blue. If they can blow a smite over this,
Oh, and Kickus out smites. No, he doesn't actually. He smites early and actually goes to Perm. Oh, wait, no. That's an old blue buff.
That's his old
buff. He did get blue. I was lied to by the buff. That was Kickus. All right, we're good.
Don't worry, they're both blue. I don't blame you.
To be fair, the old blue buff did go to Perm.
Yes.
So,
you're not wrong.
I'm just late.
By about a minute. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Anyway, they end up getting the dragon for themselves there on Loveland Shore, increasing the gold lead to 12,000. Like you said, very measured game. We saw it last time where it looked like they could possibly close the game out. They go for the delay. They go for the surefire victory. And another thing here that blows my mind is that Mockler hasn't gotten any kills this game, but he's one of the biggest threats on the team,
yes.
If not the biggest. Because if you leave him in the back line, he's just shredding people. And then Kuban jumps in and finishes them off.
Yeah, like every team fight is a sort of weird stalemate where like Denial tries to start it out. They immediately realize they can't win anymore. Kuban kills whatever straggler like got overextended. And then Denial's like, yeah, you're right. Whoops, this was a bad call. And backs out right away. And that just keeps being the case over and over again because they realize Mockler would kill them all. So Kuban, I'm really glad he's having a good game for Loveland Shore because he is the insurance policy, basically. He's the reason that kills are actually coming through at the end of it all. As he's fearless, he gets the Lulu ulties, and he goes in.
Yeah.
So that was a very required point here for this Loveland Shore lineup, where like if he was Renekton, this wouldn't happen.
No, he's extremely tanky, too, at this point.
Yeah.
And he's got that late-game scaling that'll help his team out. Kuban doesn't just bring a lot of damage to the table. He brings a lot of mitigation. He has the Thornmail, too. So the fact that they were going to try to bank on Kobe coming up huge in the damage department, it's going to be very negated against Kuban. I don't see him going down anytime soon. He might be working on a GA, too.
Oh, yeah. I think that's probably the next pick up there. And now, it's not good for Mavoon. He's going to flash away. Dragon Form comes in, putting him to half HP, but gets him out of range. Ziggs looking to defend, but Perm is very much caught out. Gets a bunch of heals, but not enough. Crescendo comes in slow. And then there's another kill picked up there. This one going to Take Fun. Top lane tier 2 definitely going to Loveland Shore. And that's going to be even more gained. 13, now going to be 14,000 gold. These guys are looking great.
Yeah, they're looking really good. They're looking more decisive in this game than they were in the last. Granted, it's a little bit of a longer game, but they're going for it.
Here we go. Top lane inhibitor turret under fire. That will be going down rather rapidly. And in they go one more time. Kuban, got to be a bit careful. Super A's takes a bit of pain. Goes in, actually. Does not quite find the kick back, though, forcing a flash for it. But that is an inhibitor dead. No minion waves in any other lanes. These guys have to back off and find another lane to push.
Yeah, they're going to go rotate towards the middle lane right now. They're actually going to go straight for it because it's low.
Yeah, already low. Backdoors that one rather quickly, and the big damage comes out. Mockler! Wow, the flash over. Take Fun didn't need to, but that is the kill picked up. Now the backdoor on towards the inhibitor turret once again. Now a 5v3, 10 seconds till Perm comes up, but that means inhibitor number 2 easily for Loveland Shore.
And now they don't have a minion wave just yet, but they're going to pick the base apart. They have so many shields, they have so many heals here that they're able to do it. Mockler off on the side. What can he do to Babunia?
A lot of damage, actually. Puts the ignite on as well, and he's going to have to back away from this one. Inhibitor turret now under heavy fire. 20 seconds of 5v4. Livik a little bit low. He's got to heal himself back up. But the third inhibitor will also go down. 41 minutes and 20 seconds into the game. Easy recall for Loveland Shore. Pick up some items. Close the game out.
Yeah, they back up. Go for the Loveland Shore style. Just dragging it out, making sure that they will secure victory.
Mm-hmm. Looks like the tides are surging right now for Loveland Shore. Ready to crash in and take down Denial. Last few items come in. Infinity Edge, full build. Phantom Dancer added as well. Yeah, this is a... his last item ended up being Bloodthirster. I was like, what is the new item in this one? And I couldn't quite tell because they're in order of gold. But that is the game. The surrender comes through for the Denial. 42-minute victory. Loveland Shore takes it 2-0.
They get to play their style to the very end there. Yep. Surefire victory in a surrender.
Yes.
Go ahead and say, you know, all of your base is just going to push in on you. Mm-hmm. At that point in the game, the super minion is going to do it for you. And all you have to do is back up and do a little bit of damage.
Yep. And they made it happen. So I got to say, Loveland Shore made a lot of good calls in a row this game. It seemed like, generally speaking, they're in the right place at the right time. Very smart team fights. The only down point was actually a great bottom lane showing by Kobe and Super A's. They had a great 2-on-2. I'd have to commend them for their individual performances. But the team of Loveland Shore swept it back up. They rallied back around Mockler despite starting 0-2-0. He ended 1-2-6. Their team fights were on point. Every dragon was the smart choice. Great game by Loveland Shore.
Yeah, great game all around from them. They really ran away with it from that dragon fight where the tidal wave came through and then we saw Denial split themselves up 2 and 3, and then they just came in with 5 members from the side, or three really big threats into the back line.
Yeah,
was the big thing there. And the support was one of the people that the frontliners of Denial were tunneling on. They're like, get Libic.
Yeah.
Why get Libic?
Yeah.
He already blew his tidal wave. He didn't really have any big threat to the team.
No.
And they spent a lot of time on him. Not just abilities, but time.
Yes, they did. And honestly, it's one of the interesting things about Tidal Wave, actually. You mentioned the skill. Is even if it doesn't hit a lot of people, it is a guaranteed displacement. Now, as an offensive ability, that doesn't mean a whole lot. If you're like, I want to kill you guys. Like, well, they back off to the
side. You Moses them. You just split them.
Yeah, exactly. As a defensive tool, as a positioning tool, it is a forced disengage. It is a forced movement by your opponents and allows you to get in position. And positioning is how those guys won the fight. You never saw Machler in a position to get hit by Wukong ever in that game, aside from lane ganks. And that was it. And you saw him play that really well. So, again, I have to commend the members of Lublin Shore. They came back from early laning visits and they played awesome. So, with that game in the books, let's see how the bracket shapes up. With that win, Lublin Shore moves into the semifinals. They're going to face the winner of tomorrow night's match between H2 Gaming and SK Gaming Prime.
And the semifinals begin next week on June 12th.